Welcome to Family Medicine in 5. We've been off for 2 weeks, so thanks for hanging in there. We actually spent the weekend in Las Vegas, and we're trying to brainstorm what to talk about, and we decided to discuss birth control. There's multiple different things for birth control. We actually try to choose a medicine that would be best for patient with side effects, with their pre-existing conditions, with their risks, and how long they want to use it. So first, let's talk about some more permanent ones. So there's totally permanent ones, like having your tubes tied or having a vasectomy, and those ones are irreversible. Think of them as irreversible. The other ones, like Nexplanon or IUD, those ones are long-term, but are just temporary as well. So the Nexplanon is the one that goes in the arm, on the inner arm here. It's a little bar. It's good for 3 years. It does have a few issues with it, and I put those in, and we do see patients, and the number one complaint is irregular bleeding. Studies show us like 80% of women have no periods, but I can tell you in clinic I don't see that. I see a lot of irregular bleeding, and usually it's not like tampon bleeding, usually it's like panty liner bleeding, but it's irregular. There's no rhyme or reason to it, so it can be super bothersome. A lot of women, they get better by 6 months, but if it hasn't improved by 6 months, there's really not much. It's probably not going to improve for the next 2.5 years. The next one is IUDs. IUDs go up inside the uterus. It's done through a pelvic exam. The worst part about that is putting it in. It can be really crampy and painful for the patient. We can give you some medicine that will soften the cervix a little bit, that may make it easier to insert. Those are good for 3 or 5 or even 10 years. So the 3 and 5 years have hormone in them. They're called Skyla, Kylena, Mirena. They're all by size. And so it used to be that we'd only put certain ones in women that have or have not had a baby. So a lot depends on how easy it is to insert it. The other one is the copper IUD. The copper IUD has no hormone in it at all. The copper IUD is great for women that have had cancer or blood clot or women that smoke because it's very low risk. But the one problem is with the copper IUD, women have really heavy periods. And so that can be very bothersome for some women. But on that same vein, there's very few options for women without hormone. Besides the copper IUD, there is a medicine called Phexxi, which is brand new to the market. Phexxi is actually citric acid. It looks like a little tampon, and you insert it vaginally about an hour before you have intercourse, and it actually changes the pH in the vagina that prevents semen from moving and getting up to fertilize an egg. That's super new. I've only had one patient choose it, so I don't know much feedback on it yet. The second one, and know that those whole lists, less than 1% of patients will get pregnant on an IUD or a Nexplanon. The next section down, it just doesn't work quite as well, but it works pretty good. It's because this row here is more user dependent. And so about 6 to 9% of patients will get pregnant on these. And it's because often patients miss a pill or they forget to take the shot or things like that. So first, let's talk about birth control pills. So birth control pills are every single day is what we say. And so if you even miss one pill, that's a window to get pregnant. And so you want to make sure that you've got to be a pill person or else it's not going to work very well. Remember, the natural hormone secretion in the body makes this wave where the estrogen and progesterone come up and then they taper off. And when they taper off, the body actually thinks, oh, okay, there's no more hormone and the egg didn't get fertilized, so it's time to shed the lining and have a period. And so with those pills, there are certain pills that we can match that. They're called triphasic pills. And so the pills will come in a pack, but the last week of the pills is always a blank week. So it's always a placebo week. The color will be different, usually like a white color, and there's no medicine in those pills. That's just for us to keep on track. So we have a period during that week, and then we start again the next Sunday with the new pack. The second one is patches. Patches go on the arm or anywhere on the body. They are on for a week. The number one complaint with patches is skin irritation, and so I don't use them very often in all honesty. And then there's Depo. Now, Depo is a shot that goes in your hip. It's good for 3 months. Out of all of them, with Depo, I do see a little bit of weight gain. And so if I have a patient that's really susceptible to weight gain, then sometimes we don't use that. But with Depo, most women have no periods whatsoever. It has progesterone only as well, no estrogen. And so you can use it if you smoke or if you have had a clot before. The other ones that have estrogen sometimes will make people a little bit moody. Sometimes it makes your breasts hurt. Sometimes it will change your skin where either better acne or less acne. It's the estrogen that patients kind of don't tolerate. Sometimes I get a tummy ache when they take the pills. So there, if you find that you don't tolerate one, we can often try another. The last one I want to talk about is the NuvaRing. So I really like the NuvaRing. NuvaRing one is my favorite. This is actually a NuvaRing. There's no medicine in it, but this is what it looks like. It's a plastic ring that has very, very low hormones. So when I have women that don't tolerate their medicine very well, I'll often try and get them to do a NuvaRing. Now, a NuvaRing will actually be inserted up inside you vaginally. You leave it in for 3 weeks and then you pull it out. My biggest pushback with this with patients is, oh my gosh, how am I going to get it in there? It's super weird that I have to put something inside me. But I always try and remind patients, this is your body. You should feel comfortable with it. If you use a tampon, you can totally use a NuvaRing. The easiest way to get it in is to take a tampon and take the actual tampon out of it. So just use the applicator. And then what you're going to do is you're going to actually bend the NuvaRing in half and you're going to squish it down into the tampon so it's in as far as it will go. And then you're going to insert it. You're going to insert it inside of you and then push it up and then it'll just come out. Remember that the nerves in the vagina, most of them are in the bottom third. And so, you know, sometimes when you put a tampon in and it feels funny and it feels weird and it's just uncomfortable, it's because it's too low, right? And you reach in and you pull it out and you reinsert it. It's the same with the NuvaRing. If you can feel it, then it's too low. Reach in, grab it, pull it out, reinsert it again until you feel comfortable, because it's going to stay up there for 3 weeks. It's not going to fall out. Trust me, it will be okay up there. Now, you can take it out for intercourse if you want to. If your partner doesn't like it, just rinse it off after a couple hours and put it back up. Remember, if you leave it out for more than a day, again, a window to get pregnant again. So you want to make sure you get it back in within a few hours. But I really like that one. So those are the options. Oh, one more thing. So condoms. So condoms, up to 10% of people will get pregnant with condom use only. But remember, condoms are the only way to protect you from STDs. So new partners, or if that's a worry for you, you want to make sure that you're using a condom, even if you are choosing another form of birth control. Birth control is only for birth control, except for hormones when we're using it for other things as well. I have a quick video after this on me putting and taking the next one on out and inserting a new one, so you'll be able to see how that works. It's pretty simple as well. If you have any questions, let us know. Thanks for watching.